I'm Matt Bramwood. I'm a full-time wizard. I'm 18 years old, and I've been doing magic for about 7 years. I started magic when I was about 12, so year 8. And I remember watching a TV show called Penn & Teller Fool Us, where they had this card guy called Michael Vincent on there. And what happened was is that I remember watching this card trick and going, wow, I need to do this. And so I actually sent him an email, just like, not expecting anything of it. And he replied back within like 2 days, and he was like, hey man, this is a book I read, this is a deck of cards I would suggest getting, have fun. And so I went out and I bought both those things the next day and just haven't looked back since. So getting into magic isn't as hard as people think it is, but getting good at it is more difficult than people think it is. So when I first started doing magic, I couldn't shuffle a deck of cards. Like, I couldn't overhand shuffle a deck of cards. And so the initial few steps, like the first few months, was just kind of card handling, and that was difficult, particularly at that age. I had really quite small hands, but after a while it gets easier, you know, you start performing tricks, and then you hit this kind of plateau of, okay, I can perform them, sorry, I can do the tricks, how do I now perform, how do I make them magic instead of just, oh, that's cool. So it's not that difficult to... I say it's not that difficult. It took me 3 years to be competent at actually performing magic tricks, but it's just really just dedication. If you're dedicated to it and you practice consistently, then I feel like almost anyone can do it. So in 2016, I was a part of a show called Deception, The Final Deceit, featuring Matt Tarrant. And so a lot of people asked me, they were kind of like, you know, what's it like working with Matt on something so big? Were you nervous, you know, meeting him and stuff? But what a lot of people don't realize is that I've been friends with Matt for about 6 years. Matt is actually the person who's kind of given me the most opportunity in terms of magic. And he's been like my mentor. He's essentially been my mentor for the past 4 or 5 years. I'm just not only performing magic, but how to kind of build myself up as a magician in terms of marketing. How do I sell, like, sell what I do to people and stuff like that. But after doing Deception last year, it kind of set me up for The Fringe for this year, 2017. Well, I went out on a bit of a limb and did a solo show called Stranger, which was a much more intimate show, smaller audience, on purpose. And it was me kind of taking what I learned from Deception and building on it in terms of my character, about what I enjoy performing and what I don't. And yeah, it was really, at least in by my standards, it was really quite successful. So over the next few years, I have a couple of major goals, and most of them are actually revolving around being on stage. Because I've been on stage performing various drama plays and whatever for a long time, like 7, 8 years. But in terms of performing magic on stage, it's something that I'm, I guess, new to. And it's something that I really enjoy. You know, after doing 13 shows straight, it's just like, I wanted to do more. I wanted to keep doing shows. This year I'm touring Stranger around a little bit, not a lot, but just, you know, going to various places performing that show. 2018, I've built a completely new show, which is already in the works right now. So we're going to do that for The Fringe. Then we'll tour that hopefully around the whole of Australia, which will be really awesome. And then just, yeah, building myself up, making sure my character's good. And then I guess the big goal is, you know, traveling internationally and performing there. The main piece of advice for people who are just getting into magic is going to be, don't get disheartened. You're going to practice things, you're going to do them, you know, 7 times in one day, and you're like, oh, I can't get it, I don't understand. No, you have to do something 7,000 times before you understand it. So really just keep practicing the same thing, and don't stop practicing until it's good. But I'm not saying it's perfect, because God, I'm not perfect at anything in terms of magic. I don't think there's any magician in the world who can do everything perfectly. But just make sure it's good, you know, make sure you can almost fool yourself with what you're doing. So that would be the main thing for people getting into magic. Just keep practicing over and over and over again. And then for if you're good at magic and you're trying to, you know, maybe break into doing some paid work or whatever, the main piece of advice I can give is talk to everyone. And I'm not just saying magicians, talk to anybody who is willing to listen, because you never know who that person might be. You never know what they're, you know, the people they work for or who they work with. You never know, you know, like I became a magician and I met, you know, Matt, and I got into that because I went to see a magic show, who I then spoke to a guy selling stuff at the magic show, who put me into a group on Facebook, who then they did meetups. I went to a meetup, I did a magic trick for one person, who put me into a charity show, and then the feedback for that charity show was so good, then I started working professionally. So it was completely just because I spoke to the right person at the right time. So just talk to everyone. And be nice. Just don't be mean. Just be a nice person. Be someone people want to talk to.